In this video, we're going to look at elemental analysis and converting elemental analysis into empirical formulas. Elemental analysis is the process in which a sample of material is analyzed for elemental composition. This can be used to give empirical formulas, which with other data can be used to determine molecular formulas. The strategy for solving these problems is to assume that we're always dealing with a sample of 100 grams. Once we have a 100 gram sample, we can calculate the number of moles of each element in the sample. Then divide the number of moles of each element by the number of moles of the element present in the smallest amount. And finally, if the ratios are not integers, multiply all subscripts by the same number to obtain integers. A simple problem: calculate the empirical formula of an aluminum oxide sample that contains 52.93% aluminum and 47.07% oxygen. The first thing we're going to do is assume that we have 100 grams. When we assume we have 100 grams, that means that our 52.93% of our sample, which actually be 52.93 grams of aluminum. Our 47% would likewise be 47.07 grams of oxygen. Once we've converted it to grams, now we can use our molecular weights for aluminum monoxide to convert this into moles. So we'll take 52.93 grams of aluminum and divide it by the molecular weight of aluminum, 26.9815 grams per mole. Our grams will cancel, giving us 1.962 mole of aluminum. Do the same thing for oxygen, 47.07 grams of oxygen divided by 15.9994 grams per mole of oxygen will give us 2.942 moles of oxygen. If we look at these two numbers, it's obvious that 1.962 is the smaller, so now we're going to divide both of these numbers by the smallest quantity. For aluminum, of course, dividing itself, 1.962 divided by 1.962 will give 1. For oxygen, 2.942 divided by 1.962 is going to give 1.499. Now we come to the point that if we tried to put this as subscripts, we'd have aluminum 1. Most often you don't see the 1. And then a 1.5. We can't have half an atom. So therefore, we need to multiply. Now you can look at this and it'll give you a clue as to what to multiply by. 0.5, we know we can make that an integer by just multiplying by 2. So we're going to take both of these values and just multiply by 2. That'll give us 2 and 3. Then we can have aluminum 2, oxygen 3. This is our empirical formula. Our molecular formula would be multiples of this. It could be Al2O3, or it could be other multiples of that. Here we've taken an elemental analysis and converted that into an empirical formula.